Hi, this is Jillian. I wanted to give you a quick little video about sharing your Loom videos with other people. Now, this is a really great option that Loom offers you, that you can send people a link and then they can access your video and watch your video anytime. However, I just want to show you a couple of things that you might want to do before you share a video to basically lock down some of your settings. So here is a video I have, three quick tips for using your iPhone. And I'm on Chrome, of course, because you need to be on Chrome to use Loom. But here I am in Safari, just so that you can see what the user is going to see when they get this video. So you can see there's my video with the animated thumbnail. And I'm going to show you a couple of things that I might want to change. For instance, maybe I don't want these little emojis displaying. You know, maybe it's a professional client I'm sending this to, and I just don't want to do the emojis. There's a way to turn those off. This is probably the most important thing. I might not necessarily want whoever I send this video to be able to download it. So that might be something I want to turn off. I might want to turn off the analytics and number of people who have viewed it or shared it. Maybe that's just something I don't want to change. Maybe that's just something I don't want to share with people. And also too, I might want to allow comments or not allow comments, and I'll kind of talk to you about the difference of both. So let's see how you would change these and turn them off. So I come over here and I click on my settings, and this is for this particular video only. It's not going to be all your settings, just on the video that you wish to share. Now, if I turn off comments, which was maybe down here at the bottom, the one thing that happens when you turn off comments, you'll also notice that it also takes off email notifications. So if you'd like a notification that the person you sent this to opened it and viewed it, then you got to leave those comments on. So it's kind of an all or nothing scenario there. Now, here's the emojis. If you want to turn those off, you would just go ahead and click that, and that turns it off. If you don't like the animated thumbnail, personally, I really love it because I find that people just, they tend to click more if they see that animated thumbnail. But if you don't like it, you can turn it off and then it's just not over there. And you can actually set this for all your videos as well. If you don't want the user to download, which I highly recommend, I like to keep my content for myself to distribute and not just have anybody be able to download my stuff. I like to turn that off. I also like to turn off analytics because I don't necessarily need everybody to see every time somebody's seen it. So I like to turn that off. And flip camera, what that's going to do is that's going to flip your video. See how it flipped me from side to side? Well, you would do that if you had some writing in the background that maybe wasn't looking right. It was reversed. So you might need to flip the camera if somehow that doesn't look right. Maybe, let's see with my cell phone, if I look over here, maybe the cell phone, it's not really affected. So in this instance, it's a mute point. So those are the things that I would change for this. And if I don't want those emojis, oh, I already turned those emojis off. So all I would have to do now is hit save. And now if we go back, we'll see, I have to refresh the screen. So if I refresh the screen, we see that you can no longer download the video. The emojis are gone. People can still leave a comment because I want to be notified that they got this. So I needed to leave that comment open, and the analytics are gone. So that's just an example of the customization that you can do before you share your videos. And when you go to share your videos, come over here and you click the share button. And if you just send a link, if you just click the one that says link, it's just going to open up and show, it's just going to show the video static. But if you do linked GIF, that's GIF, linked GIF, then that's going to display in your email as this animated picture. So non-animated would be just the straight link. If you want to have the animated picture, you want the link GIF. GIF, GIF, whatever. And if you need to, you can even embed a video on your website. So you'd have to give that to your web designer unless you do your own web stuff, but that's the embed code for that. And then of course you can share it on Twitter, Facebook, Gmail. Don't know why they don't have LinkedIn. They really should. But for the most part, I like to do the linked GIF in an email, not my email newsletter, just a straight email. And it looks really, really cool when you send that out. So I just wanted to show you this to everybody. And you can even password protect. So here over here, you can add a password. So if you wanted to send a confidential link to somebody and give them a secret password to open, you can use that as well. So just wanted to show you that. I think the most important is to switch the download off. And I think you'll enjoy sending your looms out much better so that people can't be taking your videos and doing what they want willy-nilly with them.